Hi, Bill. My name's Daniel from Texas. My question is, how do you reach someone who is maybe a conspiracy theorist or someone who is anti-vaccines? Someone who is staunchly scientifically illiterate and agree with them on what a good source of facts is. Thank you.
So, Daniel, how do I recommend reasoning with a conspiracy theorist? I'm right now, the last couple months, I've been messing around with this idea of cognitive dissonance. This is to say, you have a worldview, you're presented with evidence that conflicts with the worldview, so you either have to change your worldview, which is hard, because you've lived your whole life with it, or you just dismiss the evidence and dismiss the authorities that may have provided the evidence. The authority could be a person, or it could be a book, or, excuse me, an article on the electric internet computer machine. So you dismiss the evidence so that you don't have this discomfort, this conflict in your mind, this dissonance. That's what I'm working with right now. And apparently the way to overcome that is to say, we're all in this together. Let's learn about this together. Present the conspiracy theorist with the idea that he or she may be rejecting evidence because it's just so uncomfortable. And you're in it together. We're in it together. I'm uncomfortable too. But when it comes to moon landings, just ask the person how you would generate all that paperwork. The warehouse is full of documentation that NASA created to make landings on the moon would overwhelm anybody trying to do it on the side. It'd just be very difficult to print all that. And just understand it's a process. Somebody who has a worldview that's inconsistent with evidence, and I may have some, it takes a while for you to turn around. Like the example of palm reading or astrology, it's not something people reverse their ideas about immediately. It takes, in my experience, it takes about 2 years for somebody to sort of look at palm reading, look at cold reading or a tarot card reading for a while, and then realize that these tarot card readers, palm readers, are just taking information that you've given them, the client's given them, and feeding it back to you. It takes a long time. In the same way, people who are anti-vaccine, I think, have just lost sight of the history. Vaccines, you know, part of the reason I'm able to be here talking with you is my grandparents did not die in 1918 during the Spanish flu, when it is estimated 50 million people died. Twice as many people as were killed in combat in World War I died of this disease. If you go to old cemeteries, you can see these tombstones of very young people died of the flu. So people have just lost sight of history, and we all tend to go, well, look at the facts. Change your mind. But it takes people a couple years to change their mind. So my recommendation, Daniel, is stick with it. You'll get frustrated, the person will get frustrated, but present the idea of cognitive dissonance. This is my latest idea about a way to work together to scientific understanding.